someone asked earlier, what will you be doing tonight? I said, just a few words and handing over a big check. And she said, it's the check they want. So let me quickly dispense with a few words and get on with the check. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I wish to add my welcome and thanks to you for participating in the launch of the Shevchenko Foundation Our Legacy, Our Tomorrow $20 million campaign. Among the many organizations in the Canadian-Ukrainian community, the Shevchenko Foundation has achieved preeminence by virtue of its long track record of serving the community through its support of organizations and individuals working to further our Ukrainian-Canadian cultural heritage for the benefit of today and future generations. And let me take a moment this evening to thank Andriy Kalatyshevsky for his incredible leadership. I've watched him, you know, year after year, just plugging away and doing the job and being so passionate about serving the community's needs and interests. He needs to be admired by not just me, but by all of us, and I know you too. So. Sometimes we shudder a little bit when he strays from the written script, but not tonight. Not tonight. He was expansive, articulate, eloquent, to the point, and important to have listened to Andy. So thank you. A couple of other people to thank and acknowledge: Boris Balan, who isn't here, and the legend Lesya Shorluk. Who worked so tirelessly to bring the foundation to this moment. And I also would like to recognize my fellow honorary co-chairs, Ian Ignatovich and Martin Wieter, George Meyerhall, Jadza Butzelak, who is here, Boris Horodinsky, and Philip Crowley. All have provided important leadership to this campaign. Many community initiatives count on the Shevchenko Foundation for financial support across this land, and that support has never wavered over many decades. Just two important examples would be of programs that relied and continue to rely on the foundation for financial support would be the Bloor West Village Ukrainian Festival, now in its 19th year, which does so much to promote and make visible to the wider Toronto community Ukrainian culture in all its aspects. And another example would be Boris Shushko's production of The Music of Survival. I'm sure most of you have seen the quite inspirational history of the Bandurist chorus, which brought life to the amazing story of the Banduristi, who buoyed the community's morale and spirit in periods of despair, starting from before the Second World War and through the Second World War and continuing to this day. And I, for one, remember the Banduristi when I was a small child in a DP camp in Germany, in Munich. And the Banduristi were there and they played, and I'm sure that that had an important role in contributing to my becoming the, as my mother many decades later said, how did you become such a patriot? Well, it could have been listening to the Banduristi and that fellow with the great, you know, handlebar mustache. That's his name. But Boris, thank you for bringing that to life for all of us. And of course, thank you to the Shevchenko Foundation for providing the financial support. Louise and I are proud to be involved with the Shevchenko Foundation. We made our commitment towards the community development program to ensure that a variety of community initiatives will be supported by the foundation in perpetuity. I congratulate the Shevchenko Foundation campaign and its leadership for having crossed the halfway point in its 20 million campaign. And I encourage all of you to take the time to find a way to continue to support the Shevchenko Foundation in its efforts to ensure Ukrainian-Canadian culture and values live on by voting for Hartford. I voted every which way, but you know, many years ago when I was doing fundraising, I was chairing the fundraising campaign for the celebration of the 100th anniversary of Ukrainian settlement in Canada. I raised $1.5 million from the federal government, and I sat across the table in Edmonton from Brian Mulroney, and he leaned forward, and we were just four or five people around the table. He leaned forward and he said, "Jim, I want you to know that Ukrainians are to the Conservative Party like Italians are to the Liberals." Ivan, I have strayed from time to time. However, to your benefit. But not this year. For the benefit of Canadians and all their many natures, I should combine that to what the sentence really intended to say, which was, we made our commitment towards the community development program to ensure that a variety of programs live on for the benefit of Canadians in all their many natures. And with that, I have to check. I have to check.
Yeah.